Students, we are now in new chapter, which is chapter number 3, Algebra. In this chapter, this is the part 1 session. Students, if you see the chapter Algebra, you are learning from the lower class, which means from the 6th standard onwards, you are hearing the term Algebra. Isn't it? If you see in previous class, 7th standard, we have learnt about terms, coefficients, constant, variable, like terms and unlike terms. Everything we have learnt in the lower class. Isn't it? And also you have learnt what? Algebraic expressions you have learnt. Okay? In the lower class, you have learnt the how to add the algebraic expressions and as well as how to subtract the algebraic expressions you have learned in the lower class. Isn't it? Now, in 8th standard, in chapter 3 algebra, the first concept you are going to learn about how to multiply the algebraic expression. Okay, how to multiply the algebraic expression and how to divide the algebraic expression you are going to learn. Clear, students? Before going into the how to multiply algebraic expression, how to divide algebraic expression, before going into that, you have to know thoroughly what is term, what is coefficients, what is constant, what is variable, what is like term, what is unlike term, what is expression, what is algebraic expression, and how many types of algebraic expressions. Everything you have to know. Even though you have learnt in lower class, again I am going to recall you everything, then only I am going to start the exercise 3.1. Clear, students? One by one we will learn the concept. First we will learn about terms, then we can recall about coefficients, then constant we can recall, then variable means what we can recall, then what are like terms, then what are unlike terms, then what is expression, then how many types of expressions are there. Everything first we will recall. Then we will move to the exercise 3.1. Clear, students, all of you? Students, first concept we are going to learn about terms. Observe this expression. How many terms are there? 2x squared is one term, 4x is one term, and 2 is one term. So totally we are having 3 terms in this algebraic expression. Clear? Students, terms are separated only by plus and minus. Terms are not separated by multiplication and division. Now see this example. See, I have written terms. Now in the scene, the sign I have written in blue and red. What I have written in blue? Plus and minus can separate the term. Multiplication and divide do not separate the term I have written. Isn't it? Now, if you see the first terms in that first one, 4 alone I have written. So 4 means how many term? Only one term. In that, if I am adding plus, 4 plus x, see the next one. How many term? 4 is one term, x is one term. So totally 2 terms. Then 4 by x, 4 divided by x. Then how many terms? Whether it is 2 term? It is a one term. So if you see, I told you before, multiplication and divide will not separate the term. I told you, no. When I am dividing x, it is only one term. Okay. Now you will see the fourth one. 4 plus x minus y. 4 is one term, x is one term, and y is one term. So terms are separated by plus and minus. So we are having 3 terms. Clear? See the last example, 4 into x. 4x is a one term because multiplication and divide will not separate the term. Clear, students, all of you about terms? Next we'll see the coefficient. Coefficient is the number multiplied by the variable in an algebraic expression.
Coefficient means what? It is a number, but number it should be multiplied with variable. Variable means what? Alphabets. A to Z, we'll be saying it as in any A to Z, if you take any alphabet, that is a variable. Okay, now you see the example in below. 6M plus 5, I have written. Okay, now here the coefficient, what in the side I have written for the first one? 6. Because that 6 alone, it is multiplied with the variable M. Isn't it? Whether 5 is multiplied with any variable, any alphabet? No. So the coefficient of M is what? 6. Clear? So first one answer is 6. Now you see the second example, 8R plus 7M plus 4. Okay? Now 8 is multiplied with one variable R. 7 is multiplied with one variable M. So, what are the coefficient in the second example? 8 and 7 are coefficient. 4 is multiplied with any variable? No. Then 4 alone, if it is there, it is will be saying it as what? Constant. Clear? Now, you observe the third example. 14b minus 8. Okay, now 14 into b, so one number with multiplied with variable, so here the coefficient is what? 14 alone. Clear, students, all of you, what is coefficient and what is variable? Yes. Now you see a number in front of a variable or term. Here what are the coefficient? Here in between A, what we are having? 6. So 6 is the coefficient of A. 1 is the coefficient of B. 2 is the coefficient of x square y. Clear, students? Now you see this full algebraic expression. I have given you detailedly about what is term, what is coefficient, what is variables and what is constant. Clear? Terms, how many terms are there? 2x is one term, 4y is one term and 9 is one term. So totally we are having 3 terms. What are the variables we have taken here? X and y are variables. Okay, what is the coefficient here? In between variables, what we are having in between coefficient of x is what? 2. Okay, because 2 and into x, a number and the variables are multiplied there. Okay, now 9 alone separately we are having, which is what? Which is the constant. All those things you have learnt in where? In the lower class. We are just recapping the everything. Clear?
Students, next concept we are going to recall about like terms and unlike term. Student, this concept is very, very important because only if you know this concept, we can add and subtract the algebraic expression. Okay, now see the definition for that. The terms which have same variables are called like terms. What is it variable means? Variable means it is an alphabet with some powers you will be having. Okay, now see the example. See, for example, I have taken 2xy, comma, 2 by 3xy, comma, minus 4xy, comma, 0.6xy. If you notice everywhere, what is the variable for 2 we are having? Xy. For 2 by 3, xy. For minus 4, xy. For 0.6, xy. So all are what? Like terms. We can add everything and as well as we can subtract everything. Clear? So like term means all the variables will be same. Clear? Next we will see the unlike term. The term which has different variable factor are called unlike terms. Okay, as like term, it will not be in unlike because here we'll be having different variable factor. Okay, now we'll see the example for that. See, for example, 3ab, 2a, 0.2b are all unlike terms.
Because for 3 we are having the variable as AB, for 2 we are having the variable as only A, and for 0.2 we are having the variable only B. So these are all what? Unlike terms. Okay, now we'll see definition for, now we'll see the example for both like and unlike term. See students, I have given listed here like terms and as well as the unlike terms. Now, the first example of like term, if you see, 2x plus 19x. Okay, for 2 also we are having the variable x, for 19 also I am having the variable x. So, I can add both and as well as I can add subtract also. If it is subtract, I can do anything. For like term, we have to see compulsorily addition for and subtraction. For subtraction and addition, we have to compulsorily see what? Like terms and as well as unlike term. Now you see the second example, 4w minus 10w I am having. Here also w, there also w. So it is easy for me to subtract. Then see the third example, 14.2r minus 12r. Here also r, here also r. These are all like terms. Next, 32a square plus 9a square. It is also a like terms. 8y plus 5y. It is a like term. Clear? Now, we'll come to unlike term. 2x plus 19a. Whether x and a are same? Whether can you able to add 2x plus 19a? No, we cannot able to add because 2x is separately different term, 19a is separately different term. Next, see the next example, 4w minus 10w square we are having. So, w is different, w square is different. So, we cannot able to subtract. It is also a unlike term. Clear? 12r minus 12s, it is also unlike term. 13a square plus 9a cube, it is also what? Unlike terms. Clear? Then see the last example, 8y plus 5. Okay, here also what? It is a, for 8 I am having variable y, but for y, for 5, but for 5 I am having any variable? No. Then 5 we will say it as what? It is a constant. So, constant and the variable we cannot able to add it. It is also unlike term. Clear? Students, next we are going to recall about algebraic expression. Before that, we will recall about expression. Okay? Expressions are formed by terms. Okay? Expressions are how we are forming? We are forming by terms. See here, if the terms 3x, 2y and 1 I am having, okay? I am adding all the term, okay? We get an what expression. See in the down I have added 3x plus 2y plus 1. This is what? 3x plus 2y plus 1, it is an expression. Clear students all of you? Now we will see algebraic expression. Algebraic expression means an expression that consists of one or more variables. Okay. It will have one or more than one variable it will be having. It could contain some constants and some variables. Okay. Algebraic expression means what? It will be having some constant and also some variables. Clear? See the example which I have written down. 2x plus 3y plus 6. Here which is the constant? 6 is the constant. Which is the variable? X and y are the variable. Clear the first example? Next you see the second example. 5n. Okay. It is also an algebraic expression. Okay. A minus b. It is also what? Algebraic expression. Clear? Students, in 8th standard, we are going to learn the first new concept which is types of algebraic expression. Okay? We will see how many types are there in algebraic expression now. Students, we are having four types of algebraic expression, which are monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. Okay, how many types of algebraic expressions we are having? Four types, which is monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. We'll see one by one. We'll see first monomial, an expression having only one term. It is called monomial. Okay, monomial means how many term? Only one term it has to be. Clear? Now, see the example. For example, 3x is one term, 4xy is one term, 2ab is one term. So, monomial means it has to have only one term. Okay, 3x is separately one term, 4xy is one term, 2ab is one term. Clear? Next, we'll see about binomial. An expression having two terms. How many terms? Two terms are called binomial. Okay? See the example. 2x plus y, comma, 5x plus 4, comma, 6x minus y. 2x is one term plus y is another term. So, binomial means how many terms we are having? Two term. Similarly, 5x is one term plus 4 is another term. Here we are having two term. Now clear all of you about term. Terms all of you clear? Yes, comma. 6x minus y. 6x is separately one term. Y is separately one term. So binomial means it will having two terms. Clear? Next, trinomial. Expression having three terms are called trinomial. Okay, trinomial. Tri means what? Three terms. For example, a plus b minus c. How many terms are there in first example? Three terms. Then it is a trinomial. 4x plus 5y plus 7. How many terms are there in the second example? Three terms. See the third example. 9p plus 6q minus 5. How many terms are there? 9p is separately one term, 6q is separately one term and 5 is the third term. Clear? These are all what? Example of trinomial. Clear? Now I have splitted what is monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. I am going to give you detailly the example. Clear? Monomial means I told you, you will be having only one term. See, I have there written only one term, 2x. Binomial means I said you will be having two terms. So 2x plus 3y. See, I have underlined in the down. Monomial, only one term. Binomial, 1, 2. I have written. Okay. Next, trinomial. Trinomial means I said it will be having three terms. 2x square plus 3x plus 5. Okay, 2x square is one term, 3x is one term, 5 is one term. So, we are having here three terms. Clear? The next last one is polynomial. Clear? Polynomial means more than three terms, we'll be saying it as polynomial. 3x cube plus 2x square minus 6x plus 2. How many terms are there here? We are having four terms. Clear, students, all of you, about types of algebraic expression? We'll be having four types, which is monomial, binomial, trinomial and polynomial. Clear? Students, now in exercise 3.1, if you see the concept which you are going to learn about multiplication of algebraic expressions. Okay, in multiplying the algebraic expression, you have to know compulsorily about the signs. Okay, while doing the product of algebraic expression, you have to follow some steps. Okay, in that the first and very important step is the sign. Okay, when you are multiplying the given If both the number are in positive, we have to write the answer also in positive. If one number is in positive and the another number is in negative, means you have to write it in the negative. Clear? Similarly, if one number is negative and the another number is in negative, then you have to write it in positive. In your book, they have splitted into like signs and as well as unlike signs, they have splitted. Okay, we'll see about now what is like sign and what is unlike signs. See here, like sign means both will be same. Plus plus means you have to write the answer only in positive. Minus minus means you have to compulsorily write in positive. If both are minus, when you are multiplying, the answer should be in positive. You will see about unlike sign. If one is positive and another one is negative, by that time if you are multiplying, means surely will get the answer in negative. Here, similarly next one. If one is in negative and another one is in positive, when you are multiplying, the answer should be compulsorily in negative. Clear? All of you are clear about what is like signs and unlike signs? Yes. Students, how to multiply the monomial into monomial, I am going to explain now. Which is the first concept we are going to learn in your exercise 3.1. Okay, we'll understand the concept and then we'll move to the exercise. Clear? Now, you see, I am going to multiply monomial into monomial. Monomial means what I told you, an expression which contains only one term is called monomial, I told you. Isn't it? Now, if you see here, 4x square is one term, which is monomial. Similarly, 5x cube is one term, that is also monomial. I am going to multiply the monomial into monomial, which is I am going to multiply 4x square into 5x cube. Okay, how we have to multiply means, first you multiply the number. Okay, here the first I am having 4, in the second I am having 5. So multiply that 4 dot dot I have kept, no, which means 4 into. Instead of into, we can keep dot also. It is understood that we are having into. Clear? So 4 into 5 into x square into x cube. Okay, first we have to multiply the numbers and then we have to multiply the variables. Okay, so here what is the variable we are having? X square into x cube. Now, you tell me 4 5s are what? 4 into 5 is what? 20. See the next step I have written equal to 20. If both the base, here also x, here also x. In the chapter 1, in exponents, powers and exponents, exercise 1.6, we have learned now. If the bases are same, the power can be added, I told you. Isn't it? So, I am writing 1x, I am adding the power, which is 2 plus 3. Clear? Which is equal to 20x power 5. That is the answer. Clear, students, how to multiply? Now you see, I'm taking the monomial and monomial. I'm going to detailly tell you about the multiplication. Okay. Now 4a square into 2a power 5. Okay. Now first what we have to do? 4 into 2 we have to multiply. 4 2s are what? 8. I'm having here also a, there also a. So I have to write 1a. After writing 1a, I have to add the power. So 2 plus 5 is what? 7. So a power 7. So answer is what? 8a power 7. That is the answer. Clear students, all of you, how to multiply? Likewise, you have to do for monomial into binomial, binomial into trinomial. The same procedure only we are going to follow. Clear students, all of you? Shall we start the exercise 3.1 now? Yes.
Students, now we are going to start the exercise 3.1. Seeing exercise 3.1, the first question is complete the table. Okay, what is the first question? Complete the table. They have given in your book tabular column, isn't it? That tabular column, I am going to do the for the first one and as well as for the last one. In between remaining everything you are going to do by yourself. That is your homework. Here, the first value, the first row I am going to do, similarly the last row I am going to do. In between rows, you are going to do as assignment. Clear? Now we'll see. See, they are given here x power 4 and we are given 2x square. Here, they are given the starting into. Into is nothing but multiply. Each value, we have to multiply with the top. What we are having, no, we have to multiply there. X power 4 into 2x square. See, I have written next x power 4 into minus 2xy. Then x power 4 into x power 4 into y cube. Okay, similarly x power 4 into 2xy z. Next one is x power 4 into minus 5xz square. Like that we have to multiply and we have to write the answer in the box. Clear? Clear all of you? Shall we start now? See, first I am going to multiply x power 4 into 2x square. Before x power 4, whether I am having any number? Whether I am having any number? No number. It is understood that we are having the number as 1. So, 1 into 2 is what? 2. Then what I told, here I am having x power 4, here I am having x square. So I am writing into x power 4 into x square. Here also I am having x and here also I am having x. So if both are x, we have to write 1x and we have to add the power. So 4 plus 2 is what? 6. So the answer is 2x power 6. Clear? Second one we will see now. Now we are going to second one. If you see x power 4 into minus 2xy. X power 4 into minus 2xy we have to multiply. Now observe here, one is negative and another one is positive. So compulsorily if it is unlike sign, I have to put what? Minus sign. Then here before x I am having no number, we have to assume it as 1 is there. So 1 into 2 is 2. Here x power 4, here x power nothing is there, means in power we have to write 1. Clear? So x both are x, so I am writing 1x. I am adding the power 4 plus 1 is 5. And I am writing this y. For that y I don't have any path. So I am writing just y itself. Clear? Now see the third one. Third one is what? X power 4 into x power 4 y cube. Okay? X power 4 into x power 4 into y cube. Now here also no number before that. Here also no number. So we cannot need to write any number. Here also x. Here also x. I am writing 1x. 4 plus 4 is what? 8. I am adding the power and I am writing 8. Then I don't have any path for this. I am writing y cube. Clear? Next, fourth one if you see. X power 4 I am having here into 2xyz. X power 4 into 2xyz I am having. So, here before x power 4 no number I am having. So, we have to assume it as what? 1. So, 1 into 2 is 2. Here also x. Here also x. Here no power. So, if no power we are having, everywhere you put top 1. Okay. So, now here we are having x power 4. 4. Here 1. So, 4 plus 1 is what? 5. So, I have written x power 5. Y power 1. Z power 1. Clear the answer? Then next, last one is x power 4 into minus 5xz square. We have to do here what? We don't have any sign. So what here? Plus. So plus into minus is what? Unlike sign. Unlike sign means what I told? We have to put minus. So 5 I am writing, x power 4, here x power 1. So 4 plus 1 is what? 5. So x power 5 z square I am writing as such. These are the answer for the first row. Yeah, now we have to do the second row now. Now if you see for the second, this is not for the second row, this is for the last row. Okay, in between rows I told you I am going to do a homework, isn't it? This is the last row. If you notice in the last row, I am not having the value. They are given just dash. First I have to find the value of the dash. Only then I can find the values of each box. Okay, but if you see in that row, one value box alone they are given. Which is they have given us 4x power 5, y power 4. What they have given? 4x power 5, y power 4. Now, this number and as well as this number, if you multiply, we have to get this. Isn't it? Now, if you notice here, I am having here x power 4 and y cube. But in the answer, I am having x power 5. In x, I am having 1 extra and as well as in y, I am having 1 extra 4. So, compulsorily here, what will I get now? Here I will get x, compulsory I will get 1x and as well as 1y. But before that I am having 4. So that 4 also will come here. Clear? So now each value I have to multiply with what? 4xy. 4 into xy I have to multiply each value. So that I can find the answer for the last row. Clear? Now we'll start. 4xy into 2x square. Okay, first I have done for this is the answer. 4xy into 2x square. What will I get? Here 4, here number, here I am having 4 number and here I am having the number 2. So first I have to multiply 4 into 2. 4 into 2 what? 8. Here x power 1, here x power 2. So x power cube. 2 plus 1 is 3. So we have to write x cube. Y power 1. Clear? Next, 4xy into minus 2xy. Students, before 4, we don't have sign, which means what sign? Plus sign. So, plus into minus is what? Unlike sign. Unlike sign means we have to put compulsory minus. 4 2s are 8. Here x power 1, here also x power 1. So, in the power of x, we have to write square. Here also y power 1, here also y power 1. In the power of y, we have to write square. Clear? Now see the next one. 4xy into 2xyz. Okay? Here 4 2s are 8, x power 1, here also x power 1. So I have to write x square. Here y power 1, here also y power 1. I have to write y square and z power 1 that I have to write. Clear? Then see the last, 4xy into minus 5xz square. 4 into, first here before 4 what sign? Plus. Plus into minus is what? Minus. Because it is unlike sign. So 4 is what? 20. X power 1, here x power 1. So x square. Here y power 1, there no y. So we have to write y. Then to z square. So these are the answer for the last row. Clear, students, all of you? Now we have to write what are the answers we have got. We have to write it in the box. Students, you no need to do the first complete the table in your class book. You can straightly write the answer in the max book, which is given in the exercise 3.1. No, they have given box. No, you no need to write in the class book. Okay, you can straightly write it in the book itself. But this explanation, okay, this explanation you have to write it in your classwork. Write one, complete the table, you have to write the explanation in your classwork. If you need both the thing, I need table value and also this explanation in classwork means, you can write both the thing in your classwork also. Okay, now I'll write and show you what are the answers I have got in each box. Students, see, I have written the answer for each box. Like that, you can do it in your book or else you can copy it in your classwork. For the first subdivision alone, I am saying. Okay? Clear students, you have to draw it in your classwork, the tabular value. In below that you can write the explanation. Clear? Now we'll see the second question in exercise 3.1. See in the question, second question you are having two subdivision. You are going to do the first subdivision as homework. See the second subdivision, find the product. Product means multiply. We have to multiply in between they are given. This is one monomial, this is another monomial, this is one monomial. Because each having single one term we are having. We are going to multiply all the three terms. Clear? Now 3x square y into minus 3xy cube into x square y square. Okay? See students, how I am going to multiply means, first I am going to multiply all the numbers. I am having 3 into minus 3. No number I am having. So I am writing that first. Into. Then I am going to multiply the variables. I am having here two variables. One is x and another one is y. First I am going to multiply all the x variables. Then I am going to multiply the y variable. Here x square into here x power 1 here into x square into y power 1 into y cube into y square. Now if you see everything in multiplication, isn't it? Now here 3 into 3. 3 threes are what? 9. Plus into minus is what? Minus. Because it is unlike term. So we will get minus. So here everywhere x. So I have to write 1x and I have to add the power. So 2 plus 1 is 3, 3 plus 1, 3 plus 2 is 5. So answer is x power 5. Clear? Y, 1 plus 3 is what? 4. 4 plus 2 is what? 6. So the answer is minus 9 x power 5 into y power 6. This is the answer. Like this way you have to do the second question, first subdivision also. Clear students, all of you, how to do this? Students, this is your assignment for part 1. You are going to do the first question, complete the table. You are going to draw the table in your homework note. And below that you are going to work out for each box. Okay, that explanation you have to show it in your homework note below. Clear? And the second question is find the product. That also all the three terms you have to multiply. But if you see in the middle term we are having what? 2m square we are having, isn't it? First you have to that simplify. How will you simplify? 2m the whole square means how will you simplify? 2 square is what? 4. M square is what? M square. So minus 2mn into 4m square into minus 3mn. Okay, I taught you in the video about like sign and unlike sign, isn't it? According to that, you have to do this homework. Clear students? With this, I am completing the part 1 session. The remaining problems in exercise 3.1 we'll see in the part 2 session. Thank you students.